So I just wanted to share with you some of the items that I have attached to my work surface using command strips. I have these plastic file holders or pamphlet holders, whatever you want to call them. I just mounted them with 3M command hooks, and in this particular bin I'm holding all my rolls of various items, whether it's freezer paper, wax paper, press and seal, you get the idea. It's in that bin. I had talked about using a file folder for my Cricut supplies. However, I found when I leaned it up against the side of the desk, it leaned over too far. So the items in it also leaned over too far. And because I have a fairly narrow amount of space here, I didn't want to keep bumping into it. So I made this little holder out of foam core, and I covered it with some washi tape from Altenew. It's like a rainbow washi, which is similar to what I had done with my paper sorter. I will leave a link above where I talk about that. Okay, let's go look at the other side. So because I'm not using a traditional desk, I don't have any drawers. All I have is now this second tier that I added recently. And so I added another one of those pamphlet holders on this side, and this holds things like my rulers, tearing rulers, my T-square ruler, things for lining up titles, that kind of stuff. So I really like having that readily available. I was going to put some of my other rulers in there, like for quilting and stuff, but I found they were too long, and so I did this instead. Now the angle's a little bit awkward because this actually ends up being behind the door into the room, but I just took some more command hooks this time and attached them to the side of my Billy bookcase and hung all my grid rulers up this way. And you'll notice for some that don't have a hole in them, like this one, which is because this one broke and we just cut it off at the point, so it's still functional, but it lost its hanging hole. I just added a binder clip to that, and that works perfectly well as a hanging tool. So another update I made was for my collage items. I purchased this acrylic file holder along with some black hanging files, and in here I have all my different topics. So for instance, this one here is backgrounds, and I just have all my magazine clippings in there. I used to keep them in these folders, but I quickly outgrew this. They just wouldn't close properly, so I had to let these go. And then I tried to store them in that cart in the hanging folder section, but I've decided, and I think I've showed this already, that I put a top on it instead, which means I lost the hanging spot. So this is the next best thing. This also led me to one other change. So on top of that cart, I have this basket, and this contains all the different samples of the different products and stuff that I have. So I've got little swatches, and it fits perfectly, but it is kind of a pain because when I try to pull this out, you know, you don't know where the one ring ends and where the other one doesn't. I have some loose stuff in the front. And one of you had suggested that I put these in hanging files. Of course, this was back when I still had that hanging file section, which, like I said, I've just lost. So I thought, why not buy another one of these acrylic containers and fill it with this instead? It'll just look a little more streamlined, and the basket can either be repurposed, or maybe it's time for it to move on to a different life. I did purchase two of these acrylic holders because I'm not sure if this is all going to fit in one, and if nothing else, I have a spare for when I need it. And these are going to live over here. This is the cart that I was referring to. Don't mind this pile of stuff. Again, still working on mixed media. I will get to it eventually. But they stack quite nicely on this particular shelf. I have more than enough room for three of them. So that's where those are going to live. So let me get these transitioned over and I'll show you the final results. Okay, so here's what that looks like. It is much neater and I think going to be much easier to access. I do have them split into sections. So for instance, this here is really acrylic inks and watercolors. So I can pull out the entire section and then flip through it really easily and put it back really easily. So I'm quite pleased with that. I did have these containers here that have samples of different mediums on different types of paper, which I find extremely helpful when I'm trying to figure out what I want to use. The only problem I don't like about this is that these slide out really easily, so I think I might have to put a little bit of glue or a glue dot on them to prevent them from falling out. But these actually are too wide for in here. They're just a hair too wide. So I think I will just stack them up this way in the bin and call it done. And I only needed one bin, so the other one will be an extra. And who knows, maybe my beloved mixed media will end up in there yet. Anyways, that's it for today's organization share. I hope you enjoyed, and until next time, happy organizing.